Welcome back to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Today's episode, powered by Hayabusa, is about five different ways you can close distance quickly in a fight. In today's episode, we're breaking down five different ways you can close distance quickly in a fight. Sometimes you might get that opponent who's really good at keeping range, nice and long, uses the kicks, and you have to close that distance quickly as your key to victory. Now, I'm gonna be honest with you, it's very difficult sometimes to get in on these fighters. That's what makes them so good, keeping you away. So, ideally, I'm gonna be honest, and I need you to walk in, try to close the difference, lateral track them, but that's impossible. So my honest answer is, you need to be able to close that distance quickly. And if you wanna do it safely, I highly recommend, one, you employ these five different tactics, and two, you head over to bazookatraining.com to learn all of my different ways and tactics and concepts. So for only $9.99 a month, you get all of my lessons and concepts taught for you on a weekly basis. Okay, let's get into the first way that I like to close distance. And this one's the most safe. This is the one most people are gonna talk about, and that's the double jab, right? Close distance with the double jab, and then you can find things. Good, yes, you're gonna try that one first, ideally. But realistically, if someone's really good at bouncing and blitzing and staying long, you closing distance with that double jab is not gonna be enough, right? So, this is where number two comes in, right? Which is gonna allow you to close distance a little bit more, a little bit quicker, but you have to be competent in both stances. So number two is the shift, right? So even after I throw my double jab, right? And I throw my right hand and they're like, oh, I just missed my opponent by a foot. So I might use that double jab and shift my feet, and now look how I can close my distance down very quickly. So the double jab is great. It's that first step in managing range. If that doesn't work, step two, we go to that shifting rear hand. Now that shifting rear hand is beautiful because not only, one, does it help you close that distance, but if you land that shot and they stay stationary, the amount of power, the weight transfer, the body power behind it is just that much more devastating when you do land it, okay? So that is the shift. Now, the shift still might not be enough, and this is where you have to find principles that'll help you keep going forward. So the one I like to use, you know how much I like to use my kicks and knees here. So ideally, again, if I'm not using my low kicks, what I'm gonna do as I'm shifting my feet, if they keep moving, I wanna land this rear hand, they keep moving, I keep moving, bang! I find my scissor knee right up the middle. So the scissor knee is a beautiful way to launch that distance forward, right? I can be here and with one scissor, look, boom, I'm all the way across the other side of the room, right? I can close almost half of the ring or the cage space with just that scissoring technique, right? So if you set them up with kicks, that's the beautiful one. But really, why I like it the best is because you can close that distance and fall into a clinch a lot of times, right? Or if they do stay there and try to block, that knee is one of the nastiest knockouts you can get, okay? So closing that distance with that scissor knee, you'll realize how quick and fast you can do it. Okay, number four, I'm gonna change this up a little bit. I'm gonna add this one for more of my traditional martial artists, okay? Now, this one here is what we learned early on in martial arts, and when I was in Taekwondo, this was actually the one kick where you had to break the boards the most, right? You had your single board breaks, but when it was time to knock out the power, when you put the multiple boards together, right, this is when we did this galloping side kick, okay? So even from this position, you cross your feet and you whip your side kick. It's so that galloping side kick lets you really close that distance, okay? From that side kick, always, we get that little bounce, back foot behind, and drive that right across. One, it's beautiful because it's a lot of power. Two, you're in a side stance, which closing distance in a side stance is a little safer now because if I enter straight, boom, that's where I'm gonna get countered with a big punch. But if I stay sideways and I crash in a side position, my center line is almost covered and I can crash that distance very quickly, okay? It's almost like talking about, when I talk about my battle ram. A lot of times what I call my battle ram is when I use that tie hop and I put my knee, okay, like I'm blocking a left kick and I crash forward, right? It's that battle ram. So by staying a little bit more sideways and getting, you know, objects in front of me and my opponent, it's more safe for crashing that distance very quickly, okay? So that galloping side kick, good power, good closing of the distance, and your center line is very narrow, which makes you that much harder to hit. Now, the fifth one, which is the best one, I think, in my mind, closing that distance quickly, you want to get that power, the Superman punch, okay? We saw fighters like George St. Pierre use it well with the lead side hand, but the rear Superman is something really good at closing that distance, especially when you can just barely touch them and then all of a sudden they exit, boom, you attack them on their exit. So you're touching, you finally maybe did the double jab, the shift, all of those earlier techniques you touch, all of a sudden they escape, boom. It's that quick motion right out, and then you can close that distance super quick. So the Superman, very good setup. Now, there's so many different ways to set up a Superman. That's gonna be a different video, but one of my favorites, right? I can just throw a rear hand or a jab, and then all of a sudden, boom, you lock it in, or the ultimate one, knowing that I'm a kicker, boom, I throw the kick, up, bang, it loads up my Superman punch off of that. Okay, so there you go, five different ways to close distance safely. Remember, closing distance is about doing it safely. You're closing so much distance where your opponent's waiting for you. Why do they want that long space? Because they don't want to get hit. And the more space they have, it's the easier for them to try to time you as you come in. So closing distance quickly is dangerous, but it's a dangerous sport. It's a dangerous way to win, but you can't just sit on the outside and let them play their games. One of the best fighters who can keep you at range really well is Raymond Daniels. He keeps you at that end of his strikes. Michael Venom Page, how are you gonna close distance on these guys? Ideally, that's slow walking, but it's gonna get to a point where you might have to blitz. If you're fighting them in mixed martial arts with a small glove, I can guarantee you blitzing, if you can't get your low kicks, is gonna be your best strategy. Okay, so hope you enjoyed today's episode. Keep sharing, liking, subscribing to BazookaKickboxing.com. Make sure you also support the channel sponsors, Hayabusa Fight, which is linked below, their T3 boxing gloves, my personal favorite. They weigh that double wrist protection, the knuckle protection, one of my personal favorites. We have Perfect Sports Nutrition with all my supplements. Make sure you check out the link below. Use code Bazooka20 to get 20% off your order. BazookaShop.com for Bazooka merchandise. And last but not least, BazookaTraining.com, where I basically give you four lessons a week, right? Bag work, tutorials, sparring drills, home workouts, wherever you are in the world, whatever equipment you have available, there's a workout for you. $9.99 US per month, very simple. Every week, new workouts, new training. So these YouTube videos, you hear all these concepts, closing distance, battle ram, shield bumps, you know, head guard, slipping, ripping, all of these techniques are taught, put in a system, and they continually get better. Yes, okay, I just quickly talked about five random ways, but there's so much behind these lessons that you need to learn to do them properly in your fight. So BazookaTraining.com. All right, like, subscribe, share, all that fun stuff. See you next time here at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA.